What's up, people? It's your boy Dr. Alphonse right here. You know, seeing that we're facing this lockdown with over 16 cases, you know, in a world of economic depression, demand and supply, transportation, many companies have closed down. How do you pay your mortgage bond? How do you pay for your vehicle, you know, your rent? So many things happening, you know, and the question remains, where do we find our refuge? You ask yourself the question, where do I find my refuge? You know, let's look at Psalms 91. There's a secret to be revealed. This one says, whoever dwells in the shelter of the Most High will rest in the shadow of the Almighty. First of all, you need to dwell in something. Many people have dwelled in their finances, their medical aid. But the Bible declares you need to dwell in the shadow of the Almighty God. I will say of the Lord is my refuge and my fortress, my God in whom I trust. Who are you trusting at this moment? You need to trust the Lord Most High. Verse 3, he will save you from the fowler's snare and from the deadly pestilence. You know, this pestilence, this plague, this pandemic, it's everywhere. There's nowhere you can run to. Where do you trust? Who do you trust? That's the question. And nations like Italy, Spain, Iran, USA have been highly affected. I was checking CNN the other day and over 5,000 people have died in USA alone. And it's not that we are better than they. No, it's the grace of God. So where do you find your refuge? Verse 4 says, he will cover you with his feathers, and under his wings you take where you find refuge. His faithfulness will be your shield and rampart. God's faithfulness will not let you go. You might be afraid, but God says his faithfulness will cover you if you keep on trusting in God. Verse 5. You will not fear of the terror by night, nor of the arrow that flies by day. You will hear on social media that people have been affected, but it shall not come near your dwelling if you make the Lord Most High your dwelling place. Verse 6. Nor of the pestilence that stalks in darkness, nor of the plague that destroys at midday. Yes, there's a plague. And you must take the necessary precaution to make sure that you are indoors and you are protected and you're sanitized. But most importantly, you need to trust in the Lord God Almighty. Remember, there's nothing new under the sun. It reminds me of the story of in the Bible, 1 Kings, where there was a plague in the land and it killed over 70,000. And King David stood as he saw the angel of darkness killing people, Israelites. And he looked up to heaven and he said, Lord, my God, have mercy on your people. And God stopped the plague. So what's the secret? To go on your knees and pray for this nation. 2 Chronicles chapter 7 verse 14 says, if my people who are called by my name will humble themselves and pray and turn from their wicked ways, then I will hear from heaven, forgive their sins and heal their land. You need to go on your knees and pray and say, God, heal our land. God, heal our land. You know, this is not the time to criticize politicians, governments. No, this is a time to pray and be on your knees. Verse 8, you only observe with your eyes and see the punishment of the wicked. If you say the Lord is my refuge, there it is again. If you say the Lord is my refuge. So what is a refuge? A place of safety. A place where you can go and hide. You know, it says, and if you make the Most High your dwelling, no harm will overtake you, no disaster will come near your tent. Yes, no harm will come near your house if you make the Lord Most High your dwelling place. Verse 11 says, for he will command his angels concerning you to guard you in all your ways. They will lift you up in their hands so that you will not strike your foot against a stone. You tread on the lion and a cobra and will tremble on a great lion and a serpent. That talks about powers of the enemy. Remember that this plague is not something physical, it's something spiritual. Look at Ephesians chapter 6 verse 12. It talks about that our warfare is not against flesh and blood, but against principalities, powers, cosmic powers in the heavenly world. So who do we fight? We fight spiritual hosts that are infiltrating our nation, our world. Verse 14 says, because he loves me, says the Lord, I will rescue him, I will protect him, for he acknowledges my name. God wants you to acknowledge his name and to cry out to him as your source of refuge. He will call on me and I will answer him. I will be with him in trouble. I will deliver him and honor him. With long life, I will satisfy him. Those are the promises are of the Lord. And show him my salvation. God wants to show you his salvation if you believe in the Most High God. So friends, colleagues, neighbors, I want you to believe in God. I want you to go on your knees and pray like never before. And trust God that this pandemic will be over. God is above everything. There's nothing that happens in this world if you don't put the Lord Most High God as your source. So I want to encourage you out there to believe in God, to trust in God, and it will be over soon. There's nothing new under the sun. Remember, the storm will be over. Trust in God and pray for this nation. Pray for the Minister of Health. Pray for our government. Pray for those in authority. And God will surely bring it to pass. Have a blessed day. See you soon.